Hi, and welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Alejandro Hoyos, and we're here in Computex 2024, as you can see and hear. And right now, we're in the amazing Acer booth. With us is Robin today. Hey, Robin, how's it going?
Hey, Alex. Nice to have you back.
Good, good. It's been a while, but it's good to be back. So I see that you have two very beautiful laptops, the Swift Go 14 and the Swift Go 16. Tell us more a little bit about them.
Okay, so these two devices are our AI PCs we introduced in Q1 2024. Here we have the 14-inch and this is the 16-inch. So the special thing about the 14-inch is that we added the multi-control touchpad. So whenever the device is detecting that you're watching a video or a video is being watched, the function will be activated. Or you can simply swipe on and off on the touchpad.
And also tell us a little bit more. So this has the Intel Core Ultra, which is the Meteor Lake architecture that I was introduced last night. Tell us a little bit more about the body and also like what different I/O ports does it have and the screen too. Okay.
So we have the up to 3.2K OLED display panels, and also the body is thin and light aluminum, also the chassis and the 180 degree.
So you can actually like go all the way down 180, which is pretty nice. It has some beautiful for SD cards, USB Type-A, a security lock, which comes in handy, especially in events like this. You don't want to lose it. Two Thunderbolt 4 ports, HDMI output, and then you have your USB-A. I guess this is also serve as, well, for charging. So that's really nice. I really like it. The Swift Go 14 is also known as the AI PC. So I think you have an assistant, and you were telling us a little bit more about that.
Okay, so I think last time we talked about some AI features, Purify View and Purify Voice. So thanks to the Intel Core Ultra processors and also the NPU, which allow the AI models to run more power efficient. So this year we're introducing three more Acer AI models, which are Acer Assist, and also later on we have the LiveR 2.0 and also Vision Art. So first off, this is the Acer Assist. Basically it's a large language model integrated with a chatbot. So it runs locally. So even when you don't have internet, you have nothing to worry about. So you can ask questions about your device or the system. For example, if your Wi-Fi is down, you want to troubleshoot, you can simply enter your question and then Acer Assist will help troubleshoot.
And I think you told me earlier that this has been running actually on the Ultra Core's NPU engine.
Yeah, it's running on NPU. And the fact that it doesn't require internet connection, runs locally, it's more secure, and offers a higher level of privacy protection.
Yeah, that makes sense. All right, so let's talk about the next one. Let's talk about the other application that you guys have developed.
So the second feature I'm introducing is the LiveR 2.0, which has been evolved from the 0.5 edition. So how it works, I want to first talk about the scenario where a lot of users have difficulties entering prompts into Copilot to generate the image that you desire. So what LiveR can do for you is that you can choose the AI camera effects. So different effects like depth, pose, edge, and background blur to give you the different type of images that you can feed Copilot. So without having to enter complicated prompts, you can use that image to replace your prompt. So Copilot understands exactly, for example, what pose you want to create. If you want to create an image of a figure with certain, for example, Kung Fu pose, and you don't know how to explain that, you take a picture of yourself, feed that into Copilot, and Copilot will take it from there.
Well, that's great. So like you said, like, oh, I want to create an image from AI that shows a unicorn flexing, but you don't know how to write, like how to flex. You just take a picture of you flexing, and you actually just put it over to Copilot and tell it a unicorn, so they will understand that this is what I'm looking for.
Exactly.
Oh, that's pretty neat. And you can only, you know, not only pose, but also depth of field, blur. So you have all these different options. Yeah, that's pretty neat.
So this is run on NPU, CPU, and GPU.
That is pretty good to have three different types of engines that will help you with different workloads of AI.
Yes, the third Acer AI model is called Vision Art. So this is actually built on three different Intel AI models, including Stable Diffusion, outpainting, and Super Resolution. So how it works is that typically you get an image that's 512 by 512 on Stable Diffusion with outpainting and super resolution. We're able to enlarge that image, which will fit your screen, and also give you the 4K viewing experience.
Well, that's pretty good. All right, so this is the Swift Go 16. And this is also a Intel Core Ultra 9, also, which is the Meteor Lake architecture. It's a very beautiful, I love, also aluminum body, right?
Exactly.
It also goes 180. Like, can I open it? I'm afraid of going like,
yeah.
Okay, I thought I was gonna break it. So for the ports, we have also HDMI, and I said USB-A, two Thunderbolt ports, which is pretty good. And here again, we have also for those content creators, you have the SD card slot, you have your audio jack, yes, and also you have another USB port and also the to lock it. So this is very beautiful. Actually, it's pretty light. I really like it.
So there's actually one more thing I want to talk about Vision Art.
Mm-hmm.
Is that based on the user's setting or preferences, the AI model is able to generate images automatically based on your location, time, season, and weather. So it will just keep generating the images. And when you want to, you can also go to the menu and choose the predefined options to generate your own images.
Wow, that is great. So you guys have come up with three different great applications for AI usages that, you know, help people's life, the user's life, to do different things a lot easier. Oh, this is great.
And all of them are co-engineered with Intel. So thank you very much. No, and we look forward to more great collaborations
yes.
to benefit our users.
Thank you, Robin. Appreciate it. This has been great. Hey, everyone. I am here in Computex, and I am very, very lucky to show you guys this amazing and beautiful Acer laptop that has Intel's latest Lunar Lake architecture, which is going to be known as Core Ultra. And one of the things that this architecture is designed for is for laptops that are thin and light, which is like this. It's a beautiful laptop. If you can see, but actually open it all the way to 180 degrees. And as you can see right here, it has a beautiful HDMI port, type A, your two Thunderbolts right here. And if I go back over here, it has your audio jack, one of my favorite things, and also a type A port. We'll actually be knowing more details later on this year about the configuration of the processor. But for now, I can tell you that this guy, the architecture has been redesigned from ground. Not only for the P cores and E cores, but also from the graphics side and also the NPU. So there's a lot of different changes that has been done to the architecture so that you can actually get a longer battery life out of the system. Not only that, but the beautiful display, there's a lot of cool things coming out. So keep an eye out for these beautiful systems out there. Okay guys, so right now I'm here with Leo and we're gonna be talking about this amazing laptop that they are the Predator laptops that they are targeted for gamers, right?
Yes, actually this is the Acer's latest gen a mainstream gaming laptop, Predator Helios Neo 16. And configuration wise, it supports up to Core i9 HX desktop level the performance processor. In terms of like GPU, it runs up to 4070. So basically, this is a performance monster of Helios Neo 16. Yeah, this is
a really nice laptop. I think it's a 14th gen 14900HX.
Yes.
This one currently here runs 32 gigabytes of RAM and NVIDIA RTX 4070, which is great. And it's a beautiful system. And you said that this is kind of your mainstream system, correct?
Yes, correct. Because for us, we always think that how do we make the product perfect enough and make like everybody affordable? So in terms of like product design, we facing the highest end Intel's technology, as well as like GPU technology, RTX 40 series. So it runs with like Core i9 and up to like 64G like memory. So So basically, if you run like triple A title, it has no problem to run.
Right, yeah, you have all the hardware to do a lot of great gaming, and you're gonna have any issues with performance. One thing that I want to show everybody here, just to go over the ports that we have here, is we have my friend RJ45, which is really good. I like it. You can just directly plug in an Ethernet cable without the need of a dongle. You have your Type A USB. You also have really nice for those content creators. You have your micro SD slot. And on this side, we also have. Look at that. That's pretty cool. We have two more Type A USB type ports, and here in the back, actually, which is really nice, we have more ports, which is you have here your power port, your HDMI, and two Thunderbolt ports. Yeah. So this is a pretty versatile laptop when it comes to all the different I/O ports.
Yes.
Now, so we have this one right here. So tell us about this guy. This guy looks amazing.
So basically from the chassis design, you can see that this is Acer's flagship gaming product. This is Helios Neo 18. So obviously from this kind of chassis, you can see it delivers like full performance in terms of like CPU. It also comes with the Core i9 HX, like latest gen 14 gen processor, as well as the NVIDIA's latest gen RTX 40 series. So on top of that, on the chassis and like user behavior, we also equipped it with the swappable mechanical keycap on the WASD key.
Right, so you have actually mechanical keycaps that you can replace depending on what type of performance you want,
yes.
What kind of travel do you feel, you know? Because when gamers, we are, you know, pretty special about what type of keyboard we want to use and how do we want to, you know, how does that relate to performance? How do we do things?
Yeah.
So this guy, you were telling me earlier that you, for these type of systems, you have, tell us a little bit more about the heatsink and what you guys are using.
For the heatsink, like thermal technology, we're using the fifth gen Aeroblade 3D fan on the like our thermal system thermal design. On top of that, this year we have adopted the vector heat pipe that helped us help the system to reduce 33% on the heat that coming from the system. In terms of like CPU thermal, we're using the liquid metal grease on the CPU for like advanced usage on this system, on this kind of system. Because as you know, it runs like up to 175 watts, it comes a lot of heat. So yeah, we use like these three major technology on our heatsink thermal design, yes.
Nice, this is great. So also let me get it up here and take a quick look at the different ports that they have. So again, we have RJ45, nice, a Type A USB port. We have microSD, we have a jack, an audio jack, which is really nice. And then again, we have our two more USB Type ports. We also have a security lock, which is pretty handy. And we have your power, your HDMI, your two Thunderbolt ports, which is really nice. And you also have some nice features, colors,
yeah,
that we can show.
This is called the Infinity Mirror. So from the top view, you can see multiple layers that you can see through, because we know that the RGB concept is what gamer cares about. So on top of the per key RGB keyboard design, we have adopted the infinity mirror on the chassis design.
Nice. No, yeah. This is really good. So these are two very amazing laptops, very complete laptops. What do you tell us about? There's another one over here that we'll be talking about, right? So
yes.
Tell us a little bit more about this one.
So everybody is talking about AI, right? So Acer, for us, we have our very first gaming laptop that is also equipped with the latest gen Intel's AI processor that is called Meteor Lake. So it comes with the Core Ultra processor. This one is what we call the Triton Neo. So everybody knows that Acer Predator has like two major series. One is like the Helios. Major is the performance monster. And this one, Triton, it gives the user like more productivity and portability. So you can see from the chassis design, we're not like designing a lot of like RGB RGB effect on that. But we use the latest gen Core Ultra that comes with the NPU. So this device actually comes with CPU, NPU, and as well as the latest gen RTX GPUs that also equipped all within the system.
Right, yes, yeah, because it has the latest architecture. It has all the three different engines that you just mentioned to run any type of AI workloads that
yes.
You might be doing in your laptop. So is this more of it's still kind of targeted for gamers, but it can also be more on the side of content media creators, correct?
Yes, it supports like both the two groups. It comes with the NVIDIA Studio Driver ready. However, on the gaming experience, we have no compromise on the gaming experience. So it also supports like AAA game titles on top of this system. With the Theron system chassis design, it gives you like for the content creator that requires more portability, it gives you the ability to like carry this laptop everywhere for the content creation kind of job.
Right, yeah, this makes more sense. This is more also on the go due to the, yeah, the Intel Core Ultra, which is a lot, consumes less energy, it saves more on the battery power. So this is a very, very nice laptop. I actually like the finish. And so let's take a look at what we have here. So we have two Thunderbolt ports. One is for charging. We have the audio jack. Actually, we have here also for power, there for the power cord. And then on this side, we have the HDMI output and two more Type-A's, and you have the micro SD card over here. But I really like the look and feel. And as you can see here at the back, I mean, it's still very professional. I really like it, very clean.
Yes, exactly.
So it's really, really, really nice. Well, Leo, I really appreciate it. You spending time with us. Thank you so much. These are
thank
some
you for
great
having
laptops.
Me.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.